Welcome to Show and Tell with the Two Mortgage Guys. We come to you live on Facebook and YouTube every Tuesday at noon. Today, we're interviewing our friend, Kathy Harbaugh, Senior Vice President of the Indiana Association of Realtors. She's going to share with us some step-by-step process in becoming a licensed real estate agent in Indiana. Stick around.
Kathy Harbaugh is a senior vice president for the Indiana Association of Realtors. She joined the IAR staff in May of 2010. She oversees internal budgeting, finance oversight, insurance services, and HR. This is in addition to her roles in local liaison, core standards, governance, and leadership development for the Realtor Association. Kathy often writes curriculum for the association school, the real estate certification program, Indiana's premier real estate education provider. Kathy has served as chairman of the Indiana Real Estate Advisory Council to the Indiana Real Estate Commission since 2014. Before joining the IAR staff, Kathy was the executive vice president of the Realtors Association of Central Indiana for 14 and a half years. She obtained her salesperson license in 1978, her broker's in 1981, and her instructor's license in early 2000. She and her husband live in Westfield, Indiana, and with their pandemic tuxedo cat, Bootsy, they have two adult children. Let's welcome to the show, Kathy Harbaugh.
Thank you, Ryan and Steve, for inviting me to today's show.
We were super excited to have you. We know you bring a whole wealth of education, especially as it pertains to everything Realtor.
Absolutely, and so glad. And I'm downtown here, right across from the State Capitol building in the Realtor building. And so right in the corner of Market and Capitol. So really enjoy the view. I get to see right outside the window is my window. I can see the governor's office. So really fun. It's a fun place to work every day.
You guys ever do like sign languages back and forth with paper in the window for the governor?
Yes, yeah.
So we worked together, like in the same building. We had a nice view of. Now I'm drawing a blank. What was it called, Steve? The Louis.
Louis. Yes. When you started out, you were in the Racy building, and those were fun times. And you guys had a great little suite there. So
yeah,
fun times.
Yeah. Well, hey, today we're going to talk about what it takes to become a real estate agent, right? So, I mean, we run into people all the time that just think it's an intriguing industry and, you know, they're not really sure what to do, what the requirements are, what kind of schooling is required, all that stuff. So we thought you'd be perfect to kind of walk us through what that looks like. So kind of just leading with that, you know, how do you become a realtor?
So, you know, it's a very exciting industry and really encourage anyone interested in to contact us. But so let me give you the overview. So one, you have to at least have a high school degree or a GED, one of the two. You have to be at least 18 years old to get your license. Now, we've had people start at 17 and then take their final test when they turn 18. So that's very possible. So that is some of the process. But, you know, really they get started. It is a 90-hour pre-licensing course. It's just like a college course. It's not difficult, but it's not easy. And it takes time and a lot of reading and a lot of studying. So it's not a slam dunk by any means. And it's on the level of a college course. Once you pass the course with a 75% or better, then you're eligible to take the state exam. And the state exam is actually in two parts. There's a national part and then there's a state license law part. So you have to pass both parts and then you could apply for your license. So once you apply for your license, then you would interview, and we actually have interview questions on our website too. You would interview with managing brokers from your area, whatever area you want to practice in. Your license is good for the whole state. But whatever managing broker you're looking to, we always suggest you interview with a couple of them unless you've already made your decisions. And then you can apply for your license and get started in the industry. But that's only the first start.
Yeah, I get to the this. Yeah. So that one of those things you pulled up was like, I guess the licensing, I didn't realize it was national and state. So is it vary state to state like, does the state have some particular guidelines that you have to follow compared to like maybe Illinois or Ohio?
Exactly. So PSI is the testing company that does the state exam on the national portion for many, many states. But Indiana waits and says, oh, well, we want you to have 17 questions in agency, and we want you to have 10 questions in math. Well, other states may say, we want you to have 20 questions in math and 10 questions in agency. So Indiana goes heavy on agency than some other states, and we go lighter on math. There's only 10 math questions on this state national exam in math, which is a real bonus for some people that worry about the math.
Exactly.
I would say that's the biggest fear of most students is all about the math. And but honestly, we, you know, we get you through it. It's not real difficult, but I think that's the biggest concern for most people.
So somebody's done their 90, is that what you said, 90 hours?
90 hours.
So they do all their 90 hours, and at this point, they've not even talked to a broker. They don't have to know where they're going to work. They're just getting this stuff out of the way. And once they pass that, now it's time to figure out where you want to be employed, right?
Right. Yeah, you have to be under the license of a managing broker, what we say is a managing broker. So once you've gone with a managing broker, your education doesn't stop. You now have 2 years to complete a 30-hour post-licensing course. So you have 2 years to do a second course that's 30 hours that really takes you from the pre-licensing, here's everything you got to know about ownerships and types of ownerships, to more in the here's how you conduct business, which is different than the pre-licensing course. So now you have 30 hours. So then you know what happens after that.
The CE, is that right?
Yeah. Do mortgage brokers have to have CE? I don't even know that question. I don't know.
Yeah. So it was sort of similar like that. So like for Ryan and I, you know, mortgage bankers, initially we go through 20 hours, again, like that same point, and then you can sit down and take a test that you have to pass with the 75 or better. And then once you're licensed, then you can work for a company, and then we have to do 8 hours a year. On a topic that meets within the guidelines of the CFPB.
And I love it. I absolutely look forward to my 8 hours every year.
Well, you know, that's very similar to real estate professionals. Once you have your license and you've done your 30 hours in those first 2 years, then you have 12 hours every year. And it's a variety of topics. But typically it's very regulatory. It's about how the public can be helped by the knowledge you're gaining. So it's not about professional development, which means it's not about how you market or how you do social media or podcasts to further your business. It's more regulatory about, you know, license law and things you need to know, very basics about selling real estate. So, which leads me in more of the professional development side. So then we really, you know, stress professional development. So that's outside of CE. So that's the marketing class on how best to use some tool, best to use social media, for example, of promoting yourself and those type of things. And we are famous in our industry, a part of the Realtor family for designations. So for example, we have a designation at working with buyers. We have a designation we called At Home with Diversity, about working with a variety of different types of people. And then we have a course which we've got coming up in September. We call it the Military Relocation Certification. And this course is a great one, especially for anyone near any kind of base or even working with military. And that will be on September 20th. And I think you might have a link there. Yes. Okay. Gosh, you guys are slick. That's pretty cool. But, you know, the military course is another NER designation, which is going to be down here right across the street from our building at the Hilton on September 20th and taught by Racy's Paul Wyman, who himself is a veteran.
Right. Yeah.
So
Yeah, speaking of that, sorry, Ryan, like it's same thing like with us with the base, you know, up around Miami County. We picked up several people that were active going to reserve status or vice versa that move in and out, and they always call and say, hey, I'm relocating. When can I buy a house?
Yeah. Got somebody right now, actually, that we're helping with that. So these are like merit badges, right? You get like a sash. You get to put all their designations on them and wear them out in the public, or how's that work?
Yeah. So you'll often see a realtor with various letters behind their names. I have them behind my name, even as staff, ePro, At Home with Diversity, and RCE, which is RCE is a special designation for staff in the realtor family. So, but it is designations. I'm sure mortgage bankers, you probably have some kind of designations too. It just says to the public, I've taken my education to a new level. And that's why we suggest to members that they consider using this type of education. A lot of times you get CE for it. The military one, for example, gives you 6 hours of CE, but it just shows the public that you're taking your education to another level.
Makes total sense.
Right. We see it, you know, on our side, especially with the new realtor that comes in that has those questions, like you say, sometimes because you get licensed, but if you've not been in the industry or have somebody in it, sometimes there's just all those questions. And we're usually like, just call us and we'll see what we can do on the mass side or the finance side for them to try to help them out. But the ones that are with the managing brokers that are super involved with it, you can see a difference there. You know, they try to really that first 2 years, bring them in and teach them all that stuff, so they've got the good background.
Well, I think in any profession, education, you know, just makes us grow. And so I've been in this industry a long time, and yet I take anywhere from 20 to 30 hours of education every year. And I just think this, it really does help us to grow in our craft. So that's why I always really promote it. And, you know, another side of my position is actually in leadership development. So our members who are in the association that want to get more involved or just learn more about the industry, we have here at the State Association a Leadership Academy. I don't know if you've been through, years and years ago, actually, it's how I met my husband. I went through the Kokomo Leadership Academy. Okay. And so that was my first exposure to any kind of thing like that. And then now I run the State Association. But it's really meant for any member who is interested in our industry, whether they want to lead at the local level or the state level, or even in a committee of your community, whether it's a chamber or just any kind of committee, the Leadership Academy is really meant for you because we really take a year-long look at leadership as a whole. And most specifically, we do target a couple classes on the State Association, but we really look at leadership as a whole and how we as individuals lead every day. Ryan and Steve, you're leading in your community every day. I know you do other things besides just make loans happen. So I know you're doing other things in the community. And so this is what the course is about. So any member interesting, matter of fact, we're taking applications now to August 1st. But the IAR Leadership Academy is a great way to just take your level in the industry up another notch.
Hey, I want to go back a step. Okay, I want to recap for those that are tuning in specifically because you know what, they want to become a real estate agent. We talked about the education piece to get started, the interview process. What are the fees? How much have you spent at this point before you've even gone to work somewhere?
So typically your pre-licensing class is around $600.
Okay.
Take the state exam, it's $60. And then once you go from that, then you would be apply it at a local association, local realtor association. Those fees, I don't know, but they're somewhere, you know, less, somewhere around 1,000. I'm not real sure.
Per year or?
One time, but then you have annual dues. So, and okay. I don't know what those would be for each association, but if I always say, if you woke up today and you say, I want to be an entrepreneur, this industry gives you the biggest capability of being an entrepreneur for really a low rate of investment to start with. You can't go out and buy a franchise for as little money as you can in the real estate industry to get started and really have a large potential.
So you're $1,500 to $2,000 ballpark to kind of get started in this. You've interviewed now, you've found an office. Of course, you're going to want to lean on that office and that broker for some additional mentorship, I'm sure. Exactly. We've had people work for us over the years in the mortgage industry that didn't necessarily know what they were doing when they started, and we spent a lot of time training them. So I'm going to imagine it's the same thing if you're a real estate agent. When do you start making your millions of dollars? At what point do you...
Well, you know, it really depends on the individual. And I've seen agents just, you know, kick it their first year. And I've seen agents who have it. And it really depends. And I don't know if there's a secret formula for that at all, Ryan. Every agent is different in their goals and what's motivating them. I've seen a lot of single moms get in this industry and have a fabulous career. And I've seen other people that this is kind of their second career, and maybe they're semi-retired, but yet they still want to be doing something, and they're fabulous agents. So I think there's something there for everyone. It just kind of depends on the person and where they take it.
We've seen a lot of new people since we started. You know, Steve and I have been doing this for almost 20 years, and when we first started, I felt like, at least in our market, there were a lot of agents that had been around a long time and not a whole lot of new agents. And in the last 6 years or so, I feel like it's switched. We've had a lot of newer, younger agents coming in at different levels, like you said, whether they're full time or if it's secondary income. Some of them probably ended up doing better than they ever thought they would. And now all of a sudden they love it. And they're more full time than maybe they thought initially.
Yeah, it's interesting. We saw a lot of real estate as a second career. Matter of fact, it used to be our average age was 57. And over the last, as you said, 6 years, the age has been dropping. Now it's down to 54. There's actually more women in the industry today than there ever has been. There's more women in the industry than men. And the age is dropping. So where we weren't seeing a lot of the younger, let's say under 30, that's definitely been a growth zone in the industry in the last 6 years. And so it's kind of interesting. It's very, very much changing. And it's great, you know, to see that too.
Yeah, it's good to see. And because that's the same sort of like thing in the mortgage industry that they look at too, is if there's not newer blood coming in, eventually we all start to get older and retire, right? So
you're getting older, I'm not.
yeah, but we've noticed that it's starting to pick up some younger loan officers, and you've got to have that to be able to keep our business floating like what it is.
Well, seriously, Kathy, we haven't seen you in quite a while. You don't look any different than the last time.
Well, you're very kind, but I got my license right after I turned 18 initially, and I spent my whole career in real estate, one fashion or another. I sold real estate when interest rates were double digits, and guess what? You could sell real estate when interest rates are double digits, and I was a single woman. So I knew I had to make sales in order to support myself. But I think you see, you know, just a wide variety of people get into the industry. I think it's really exciting because everybody that gets in brings a different perspective, and they bring new clients with them. And so it's good. We are at record numbers, though. I mean, we are today at record numbers in membership, and that we've not ever seen.
Wow.
That's good. That's really good.
Anything else that you want?
Like in general, like Indiana's pretty well recognized throughout the nation too, isn't it? With things that you guys do down at the State House that helps keep us afloat and noticed.
Well, we have a fabulous governmental affairs team here. Maggie McShane's our senior vice president of governmental affairs, does a great job. You know, she can come on and tell you lots of stories of things that have happened. And she does fabulous. And, you know, we have a great staff that provides a lot of stuff to our members, and we're very proud of it.
And so for that same thing, when you said you guys are downtown, like anybody that's a member, right? Like if we're downtown, just pop in the door and can say hi to somebody down there. And because I know Ryan and I have been down there before, and we actually didn't walk in because we're on our way someplace else, but it probably wouldn't take much just to pop in there and say hi to somebody.
No, you can't miss it. We're on the corner of Market and Capitol, straight across from the State House. There's a 15-foot realtor sign on the side of the building, so you're not going to miss it.
Right.
I encourage anybody to stop in and visit myself, Kate Mays, who's originally from Kokomo. We love taking members on tours of the building. And my office is on the 8th floor. We occupy the 1st and the 8th floor. And so we're happy to, you know, take anybody on a tour. It's really cool. And we actually have a wall of every county in the state. And guess what? Howard County, what picture of what building is on Howard County? Let's see if you can figure this out. Famous building in Howard County on Sycamore Street.
Cyber Lane.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. The Cyber Lane's on the Howard County plaque.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. It's got some landmarks in there with it too, and you can recognize them.
Yes.
Pretty cool. Well, what else do you want to cover? Right, we covered a lot here, but is there anything else you want to mention? I know you talked about some upcoming events and.
Yeah, no, I just invite members to, pencil in September the 19th. That is our stakeholders meeting. It targets leadership in the association, but it's really meant for anyone. We're actually going to have a really interesting panel discussion. It's titled No Houses, No People, No Jobs, and it's going to be made up of several economic development professionals from all over the state. And I would really encourage, I think that's going to be a really interesting panel. Not only that, we'll have a lot of different other presentations. And one that's going to be coming to our website really soon on indianarealtors.com. If you visit our website, there's a area there for monthly data. And so we collect data from all over the state. We post it by county. And on September 19th, we're going to release our new mechanism for reporting that data. And I think you'll find it very interesting because the old data is more stagnant. Like, here it is, guys, look at it. Where this new one, it's more interactive. So you could say, okay, I want all of Racy, for example, which is Howard, Tipton, Wabash, Cass in Miami County, or I just want Howard County. And it's just going to show a variety of information out there. And so some interesting little things in there. But we do have by-county data right now on our website that anybody can look at. And this new mechanism that we're releasing in September, again, anybody can look at it. And it gives you county by county and really drills down some data.
Yeah, that's interesting because I know that a lot of realtors we talk to, they like looking at that data for areas around them, you know, just to see where they're setting at with it. So,
yeah, Janice Childress is our data scientist on staff. And I always call her, she's one of the cool kids, you know, she has all this technology and stuff. But today you can look under consumers and housing data on our website to see what we have today. But I think it's going to be really exciting what we're getting ready to release.
Pretty neat.
Awesome. Yeah. Hey, and then on just like a little side note on it, Kathy, because I know that we talked and you're a wealth of information. So thanks for taking your time to share a little bit with us on it. And we've got like a bunch of other topics that we're going to start to try to work Kathy into or some other people from down at IAR to cover that. So
I'd love for you to have Mark Fisher, our new CEO. He's really trying to get around the state meeting people. And so I'm inviting him.
Oh, there you go. Oh, for sure. His name down. So yeah, we'll have Carrie reach out and get a hold of Mark and try to see if we can get him on pretty soon and then rotate you back on and some other people down there, because it's very impactful information. Like Ryan said, there's people that want, or they're interested in this, and how do we go about becoming a realtor in Indiana. So,
and I feel like we gotta get Kate Mays on too. I mean, just because she'd be a trip, right? Kate's always fun to talk to.
Yeah, Kate is our event manager of the building here, so we love her. She takes I call her the mom of the building because she takes. We have tenants on several rest of the floor, so we have 8 stories. So we're occupied 1 and 8, and we have tenants all the way through. So she works a lot with the tenants, things that they need, but we call her the mom, though, of the building.
Get her in there. That's awesome. Well, hey, before we say goodbye to Kathy, if you guys liked what you've heard today, or if you have questions, now just put it in the comments down below. And then what Carrie's going to do, she'll feed all those back into Kathy to be able to get those answered back to you. So like, share, comment, spread this out. And if you guys have any other questions like that, feel free to make comments and Kathy will help you out.
Happy to. Thanks, Steve. Thanks, Ryan, for inviting me today.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, so next week we're going to be interviewing Sammy Holmgren from Remax, a new realty in Tipton, Indiana. What's the real estate market like in Tipton? What's the average home selling for? What are the benefits of living in a small town? All this and more. Be sure to tune in and watch us next Tuesday at noon.